You're listening to The Living Word from Grace Faith Mission International with Reverend GABIGA CLEMENT.
If the light will destabilize the generator, then put it off. I prefer the voice. Amen. And when it's stable, leave it at that. Let's manage it. Amen. I have this announcement to make. It's a glorious morning. It's a beautiful prayer. The faith series. And today, we'll be touching on the God kind of faith. Amen. I'll be teaching some mind-blowing, spirit-elevating things here. My dream, if you put on that light and that generator goes down, you'll become generator. Amen. Okay. I've been teaching some things. I realize that my calling is not only to lay hands on you. My calling is to teach you as I lay my hands on you. I am producing, by the grace of the Lord is producing through me, a generation of people that shall, who are downloaded with the secret for advancement. I am not only giving fish, I am giving nets. Are you understanding me? And that is why we are producing a solid church. It's coming a season when if there be no preacher, no man to lay hands on you, you will lay hands on yourself and get your miracle. Yeah. Are you understanding me? Yeah. I will not always be there to leave you baby Christians. That is why time and again, as I minister in the power of the Holy Ghost, I also teach you the secret for advancement. So that when nobody is there, you can handle your situations. Hallelujah. Yes. I am turning Christians to pastors. Yes. Are you understanding me? Yes. Because it's coming a time where in your quarter, you shall be the pastor of that quarter. Yes. They shall look up to you. Yes. Men shall trust the grace of God in you. Yes. Can somebody say big amen? This morning I'll be rebuking sicknesses and diseases, prophesying, but I want to give keys. I want to beg you again and pause and beg you and say, bring people to the scene. And I beg you by the grace of God, it's not pride, I'll bring God to the scene. Amen. Yeah, a few people hurt me. In this fire night, bring people to the scene. You by the grace of God is not pride. I will bring God to the scene. So this is division of labor. It's my father I know. Amen. Yeah, whatever you do, whatever you say, it's my father and I know what I'm saying. I know how to trigger him to come to the scene. Each time I love him and praise him, he comes. This week we shall be triggering and bringing daddy into the scene. Pity the devil that will come against your life. So, bring the people, I will bring God. Hallelujah. The God kind of faith. You say God has faith? Yes. I will show you from scripture. Faith in who? Faith in himself. Go with me, we shall be using this scripture. I want to teach on faith. We'll be starting the faith series. And as we go through this faith series, let me tell you, your faith will be so buoyant and strong, vibrant and powerful. Are you understanding me, somebody? God told me while I'm worshiping them to tell you. He said, son, tell my people, many of them are now becoming fearful. The enemy has terrorized them, frightened them, and now they are afraid, and unbelief is entering into their heart. He said, tell them that I am the pillar of fire behind them, and the one that breaks the Red Sea in front of them. He said, this time I'm not appearing as a pillar of cloud. I am appearing as a pillar of fire behind them. Whosoever is pursuing them from behind will confront me. looking at that. I said, this is what God told me when I was worshiping. He said, tell. I did not want to raise up my voice and say, thus says the Lord, but this is thus says the Lord. He said, I should tell you that he is the pillar of fire behind you. I don't know who is pursuing you from behind. He's at the risk of his life. Are you understanding me? I don't know the witch that is pursuing from behind. He's at the risk of his life. And then he told me, he said, I have gone ahead to break the Red Sea in front of you. If he was talking to you, shout a big amen. If he was talking to you, say, Papa, I hear you. Take your seat. Fear not. Mark chapter 11. I'll read from here because we have several scriptures to read. Before I let you go, Mark chapter 11, from verse 12 and 14, 19 to 24. Mark chapter 11. Holy Spirit, thank you. On the morrow, when they were come from Bethany, he was hungry, and seeing a fig tree afar off, having leaves, he came in haply he might find anything thereon. And when he came to eat, he found nothing but leaves, for the time of the figs was not yet. Amen. And when evening was come, he went out of the city. That's verse 19 now. And in the morning, as they passed by, they saw the fig tree dry up from the roots. And Peter, calling to remembrance, said unto him, Master, behold, the fig tree which thou cursed is withered away. And Jesus answering and said unto them, have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass, he shall have whatever he says. Amen. I shut down my laptop, my notebook to open it. It will take some time. But I wanted to read the Weymouth edition and the Dowie edition of the scripture. That verse 23, it says, in King James version, also in your version, it says, have faith in God. But in the Dowie's Rheims Bible, it says, have the faith of God. That is what I want to build. The original translation of that scripture is not talking about have faith in God. It says have the God kind of faith. Amen.
Amen.
Have what? Tell somebody beside you, have the God kind of faith. Tell him again. This is a scene where Jesus was walking. And the Bible says, he came and saw a fig tree. He was 100% man. Amen. That is why he was hungry. One brother met me some years ago. He told me, he said, Jesus committed a bit of sin. I said, why? He said, he was hungry. I said, you stupid. You don't know the composition of Jesus. He was 100% God, but 100% man. And on earth, on very few occasions did he use his divinity. He used his total humanity. That's why he was tired and he could be hungry. Amen.
Amen.
And so, he was hungry and saw a fig tree and expected fruits and went to the fig tree to harvest some fruit. And somehow, he was deceived by the leaves afar off. And when he came closer, he discovered there was no fruit. And he got angry because he was 100% man and looked at that tree and said, because there is no fruit on you, your leaves have deceived a lot of people. Hey, from this time, no man eats any fruit from you. He spoke one word, one sentence, and he left. Well, the Matthew's record says it dried up instantly. Mark's record said they went, and on coming back, it dried up. Both ways, immediately he passed the curse, the tree started drying up. Amen. Are you understanding me? And when Peter looked at the tree, he said, Master, this is a tree you curse. It's just withered to the root instantly. And Jesus replied and said, have faith in God, or have the God kind of faith. And he said, verily, verily, I say unto you, if you have faith, which kind of faith? The God kind of faith, you shall say to this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea. He was not talking about spiritual mountain. There was a mountain standing in front of them, a physical mountain. He said, you shall say to this mountain, get up from here, and the mountain shall obey you. Are you understanding me?
Yes.
Jesus was talking to human beings. He was talking to disciples. If you were there, then he would have been talking to you. What was he saying? That me, Clement, GABIGA, I can talk to this speaker, move from here to there, and it displaces. Yes! That is surprising. But he says, you must have what? The God kind of faith. How many people want to have the God kind of faith? That mountain moving faith. I want to show us some few places where Jesus operated the God kind of faith. When he stood before the tomb of Lazarus, he did not holler, he did not scream. He shouted one shout, Lazarus, come forth! And Lazarus did not walk forth. A certain wind, resurrection wind, brought Lazarus and stood in front of him out of the tomb. Decomposition became composition. Are you understanding me?
Yes.
Jesus operated a God kind of faith. This was a faith he walked upon the water. Are you understanding me?
Yes.
It's possible. And he said, greater things shall you do than this. Because what? I go to my Father. Which means the same things Jesus did, you can do. I can do. When we have what? The God kind of faith. If you have the God kind of faith, which is the God kind of faith? The God kind of faith is not that prayer begging faith. Oh God, I beg. Father God, help me. My enemies want to kill me. Oh God, it may be you. Better know them. No! The God kind of faith is that faith that stands your ground. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And any enemy that comes against me, God does not need to come down from heaven. I am here. Are you understanding me? The God kind of faith is that faith that does not panic. Some years ago, Archbishop Benson de Dahosa, the late Archbishop Benson de Dahosa, had a confrontation with witches in Benin City. They said they are going to hold a meeting in Benin City. And Archbishop had an open meeting, not in the night. Open meeting in the day. Some of them have complimentary cards. And so, the Archbishop got up and said, this nonsense can never be in Benin City. When I confronted the witch who was publicizing the matter over the television, I said, it cannot hold. And the witch replied to him, even God cannot stop it. Archbishop turned around and looked at the witch. He said, you are right. Even my Father will not leave heaven to come and stop small 3,000 witches when I am here. I did not say God said. I say, it will not go. That's a God kind of faith. Then while the camera was on, because the television program, he looked at the wizard in the eyes and said, repeat that, it will hold you, drop dead now. The man was quiet. That is a God kind of faith. And that is where you are going to. I say, that is where you are going to. Let me show us the characteristics of this God kind of faith. In this passage we have read, Jesus spoke. Can I teach you here? Jesus spoke in Genesis chapter 1, verse 3 and 4. The third kind of faith is that faith that speaks before it sees. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse 3, it says, and God said, let there be light. Before that, the Bible says, and darkness covered the face of the deep. Are you understanding me? What was visible? What was in front of God? Darkness. Are you understanding me? But God spoke first. He did not wait. He did not consider the darkness. He said, light be. He spoke before he saw. The reason why your faith fails is because you see before you speak. You talk like Thomas. If I cannot see and put my hand there, I cannot believe. No! The reason why you always confess negative and speak negative things in your life is because you see and you do what? You speak. But change it. When you see an echography report and it says you have fibroid and you need a male child, what do you speak? Oh yes, thank you, choir. God bless you. Because if you look at that echography report, and that is what you speak, because you need to see first before you speak, the devil will mess you up. Let me go faster. So the God kind of faith sees first before he does what? He speaks. Let's go faster. Romans chapter 4. I read from here. Romans chapter 4. I want to explain some things faster. Read the scriptures faster so that I'll minister to you. Romans 4. I'll begin from verse 16. Therefore, it is of faith that it might be by grace, to the end the promise might be sure to all the seed, not to that only which is of the law, but to that also which is of faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all. As it is written, Mark verse 17 now, I have made you a father of many nations before him whom he believed. God, listen now, who quickeneth the dead and calleth those things which be not as though they were. Stop there. I want to open your mind. The second characteristics of this God kind of faith, I said number one, the first one does what? It speaks before it sees. You need money, you call the million first before you see the million. You don't wait to see the million before you say it is a million. Are you understanding me? Yes. Number two, he called the things that be not, that don't exist, as though they existed. That is the principle of God. That's a God kind of faith. That is the language of God. Go to the book of Isaiah, chapter 9. He says what? Unto us a child is will be born. I said, talk to me. Unto us a child will be born. Is born. Was Jesus yet born? Isaiah was talking so many years ago. Can I tell you something? God speaks the future in the present and speak the presence in past tense. Are there English students here? I say God speaks the future in the present and speaks the present in past tense. Are you understanding me? He said, unto us a child is born. He was talking about a girl that has not yet been born, who shall deliver a child called Jesus. And if that is the language of God, do you expect that womb? You are expecting a baby and you are saying, no! Hold your hands and say, unto me, a child is born. of us who watch cables and dishes and channels, you know about Bushiri. Some of you know about this man of God, this young man. He said he has jets. I don't know how many numbers now. He has personal jets. He said when he had no jet, he went. His faith was strong. He went on the Facebook and said, thank God for my new jet. The criticism that he had all over the world, these lying preachers, and news went all over. It wasn't long he had his physical first jet. Oh my God. Your problem is that you like to see before you talk. If you can have this kind of head that tells you tell yourself, I like that Bakasida. Even though my eyes cannot see it, it is there. Are you understanding me? You went to the hospital and the doctor told you that your baby is not a baby. It is a phantom pregnancy. You tell that doctor, there is baby in my womb. Ogasa, watch 9 months. God gave me baby. Are you understanding me? He wrote it there. I have my first jet. People criticize. What happened? The jet came. Why? God calls the things that are not as though they were. This is God. The name Abraham, oh my God, I have some students here. I have some people here. The name Abraham means exalted father, assumed father. But the name Abraham means father of many nations. Sarai means exalted mother, assumed mother. S-A-R-A-I. But Sarah with H at the end means mother of many nations. When they were still barren, God came and met them and said, from today, your name shall be father of many nations. You girl, your name shall be mother of many nations. What happened? There were two of them in the house with only servants. And Abraham will call, mother of many nations. Sarah will answer, yes, father of many nations. They were the mockery of the town. But which of us is not identified with Abraham now? Why? God calls the things that be not as though they were. What do you need? Start calling it now. What do you need? Change your language. Tell your neighbor, change your language. I said, tell your neighbor, change your language. You say, pastor, I'm struggling to run up in this advanced level. I will go and do computer study when I finish my advanced level. I want to do tailoring because I don't get someone for my before. I don't get someone for my back. See, can I tell you something here? Take a piece of paper. Hold that blank sheet of paper. Write it with bold marker. Was always negative, and he took something, he inscribed it and said director of companies, pasted it in that child's inner coat, and that child was walking with that coat, going to school with that coat, come back with that coat. Every time the child changes that coat, the father will insist that put on that coat, and each time the child looks at this thing, he did not first believe it, but something was planted gradually inside his mind. A mindset of greatness, of rulership, started entering this boy because of what was put. Along the line, by the grace of God, he became director of companies. Are you understanding me? If you can believe it, you can see it. Can I give you a secret here? Each time you believe it, say it. Even when you don't believe it, do what? Say, pastor, my own poverty, you don't plenty. Thank God it's your own. See, if you think you are poor, go to printing press. Gather papers, shape them like this, put them inside, place them in your house. Say, these are my millions. Take papers and say, these are my checks. I believe in prosperity. How many people don't have a bank account here? I'm teaching crazy for this money. Some of you here, can I give you an assignment? Yes. Will you obey? Yes. Go to UBA. Yes. Go to Echo Bank. Yes. Just enter there and stroll. Yes. Look at the place. Yes. Some of you. Yes. When you enter there, ask the manager. Yes. I'm sorry, sir. Some years ago, I went to Douala Stadium. I stood in the stadium. I said, oh, you stadium, you are not made for football. I will preach in you. I will preach in you. And do you know what? Watch it. My crowd is getting bigger. My crowd is getting bigger. My crowd is getting bigger. Get that kind of faith. If you can only speak it, you shall receive it. Some of you girls who keep dressing like, do you know what? When you dress like a prostitute, you are prophesying to yourself that I cannot get married. I'm sorry, because if you need a husband under that prophetic anointing, dress like a responsible girl. Because when they see you, are you understanding me? They will know this one is a wife material. Some people say she dressed like Maria Maka. Maria Maka left her house, you receive her with her outside. Are you hearing me? Yes. Put up something that meets your faith. The Bible says, God who calls the things that be not as though they were. Class 7 here. Go tomorrow. Enter the university campus. Move from faculty to faculty. Say, I am coming here. I am coming here. I am coming here. I am coming here. Bishop Abioye said, the easiest way to build a house is to get a plot. The moment you get a plot, find 65,000 francs. Take a dipper of sand. Throw it in that place, tell that land I'm coming back. Are you understanding me? Are you understanding me? Fear not, it is possible. If you can speak like God, you shall have it like God. Take your seat, let me go faster. Oh my God. The faith, the God kind of faith. Let me explain something. The Bible says, Abraham, I don't want to be too emotional, but will you give me time to build your faith? Yes. The God kind of faith. Yes. The Bible says, Abraham, who against hope, believed in hope. Now, 1 Corinthians chapter 18, the last verse, I don't know where it's verse 8, check it. 1 Corinthians chapter 13. The last verse is which verse? 8, not 8, 11. It's 13 too. Yes. He says, there abided these three. Faith, hope, and love. Look at me here. We're doing mathematics. Faith, hope, and is what? No, you missed it. It's hope. If he says faith, hope, love, and the greatest is the last, then the second greatest is the second. Are you understanding me? Which is hope? I'll explain between hope and faith. Faith is that belief to get it for now. I have the belief. I believe it. I can take it now. Hope is that trust, that total relying trust, even when it fails. Is hope is greater than faith, because if you tell me that meet me here, I'll give you money, I have faith that if I meet you there, you will give me the money. That's faith, right? Yes. When I reach there and you did not give me the money, and then I still trust you, that is now faith. That's now hope. Are you understanding me? Yes. Whatever the incident that made that thing fail, or whatsoever, that trust that I still have for you is what is called hope. In hope, when things fail, when faith fails, it lands on hope. Hello? Faith is a height, but if it fails, it will land on what? On hope. That's why the Bible says hope never fails. If you end up hopeless in life, your own case won't finish. What am I talking about hope? Hope is somebody who came to church and said, today I'm receiving my miracle. God is visiting me. Why they were singing, their hand was so open and said, Lord, I am here. They said the first person to shout the big amen will receive the biggest miracle. He shouted the biggest of amen. And then suddenly, after all the prayers, the pain still stood. Faith failed. But then he turns and says, even though I still sense the pains, my God is a healer. I believe that if it did not happen today, I still have faith. I still have that trust that God is a healer. He will take this mess away from me. And so I can never be broken. I can never be disappointed. I can never go down with a downcasted face. I can still praise God in the midst of the pains, knowing that a day is coming that he will answer me. That is hope. And you know what? It's greater than faith. People who have faith without hope, when faith fails, they backslide. The Bible says, the case of Abraham, the case he exercised faith, faith failed. He had hope, but it came to a point that hope was failing. Against hope, the Bible says, when a woman is 40, getting 45, that's menopause, right? Cessation of what? Menstruation. Beautiful. When it is 85, that's twice menopause. Twice menopause. Or like grand menopause. Okay, anyhow. Now, Abraham was not suffering from no sperm count. The Bible says he was dead. His manhood was dead, no erection, at 100 years, 99 years.
To worship with us this Sunday, 9 a.m. at the dot. Grace Faith Mission is located 200 meters behind St. Clair Hotel, Moliko Buya. For more information, contact the numbers on your screen.